improve the elasticity of the creams and fruit supplements.
Sodium, CBS Mondays.
Taxpayers, but the
people running for president, they've been called a billionaire's club. They're mainly very wealthy, very successful people. And some of cabinet members, I know Betsy DeVos, and I think there's one more, actually take their own way on their private jets and do not charge the government back. So they are above criticism of their mode of transportation. But Secretary Price chose not to go there.
Yeah, it's clearly not a directive from the White House on how these people are traveling. It's clear that the White House was quite a bit off guard with the level of spending that Tom Price did. I mean, it is pretty surprising amount of money that was spent on military and private jets to fly to these places. But you're right, it's, if anyone can manage to have others that are coming to the oil scandal, most notably the administrator Scott Pruitt, Treasury Secretary Mnuchin, and Treasury Secretary Ryan Zinke, to name a few. So there's going to be a lot more scrutiny on this. But again, I think there's especially a lot of scrutiny on this because of what the president has said repeatedly from the government, which was on hold to carry this far in Washington. This is the kind of thing that goes completely against that. The president said himself the optics are terrible.
Administration after administration. And it's not just at the federal level, but you see the state and local levels, people working about.
guy someone to flying coach on commercial. It's one of the most miserable experiences you can have.
I think the big lesson on this is the man that's replacing Tom Price. I'm sure he's very familiar with the government travel computer program to figure out how to get the places commercial.
Blessings learned. All right, Steve Shabiris, thanks so much.
Thanks.
President Trump is defending relief efforts in hurricane-ravaged Puerto Rico.
We're undertaking a massive federal mobilization to assist Puerto Rico, including the presence of over 10,000 federal personnel, including 5,000 U.S. military and National Guard personnel, led by a very, very strong and talented three-star general. All appropriate departments of our government, from Homeland Security to Defense, are engaged fully in the disaster and the response and recovery effort probably has never been seen for something like this. This is an island surrounded by water, big water, ocean water.
The military is leading efforts to clear roads and bring basic supplies to millions still in desperate need after devastating storms swept through the island. Hospital ship has left Virginia today to bring medical help. Weecha Jiang is at the White House with the latest.
President Trump took to Twitter this morning, once again praising the federal response to the disaster in Puerto Rico, writing in part, "Thank you to FEMA, our great military, and all first responders who are working so hard against terrible odds." Thousands of service members, including the Puerto Rican National Guard, have been leading efforts to bring food, fuel, and supplies to the hurricane-ravaged island. They include Marines and sailors from the USS Kearsarge, who have set up a high-tech operation center there.
What we've been able to do is to find the critical infrastructure, find the nodes where we can save the most lives if necessary.
The USNS Comfort is also on its way to Puerto Rico to assist areas where medical facilities are crippled. The vessel has more than 850 service members and 70 civil service mariners on board. It's traveling with 5,000 units of blood, 4 x-ray machines, a dental suite, a pharmacy, and a physical therapy center.
We'll go out there and hit the ground running, or hit the deck plates running, as we say in the Navy, and we'll keep moving until somebody tells us that we're no longer needed.
Despite those efforts, President Trump is facing criticism for what some view as the government's slow response to the U.S. Commonwealth. But the Trump administration says the problem really lies in getting supplies from the ports to the people. On Thursday, President Trump waived the Jones Act in Puerto Rico to help ship goods to those affected. Mr. Trump says he'll visit the island next week. Weecha Jiang, CBS News, The White House.
And David Bengo joins us now from San Juan, Puerto Rico. David, it's been 9 days since Hurricane Maria made landfall. How are residents dealing with the long lines and the low food supply? I mean, are people at a risk of actually starving there?
Absolutely. I mean, look, Don, here's the deal. How are we dealing with it? Two words that I haven't used to the fund right now are missing and professional creation. But let me say this, they're growing weary. You've got people who stocked up before the hurricane, they're starting to run out of the food of their food supply. They are surrounded by water in Aguadilla, where we just came from, yet they are so desperate for a drop to drink. Okay, I cannot stress to you how dire the situation is in the area where we were, in sort of the main city center today, where the mayor of Aguadilla had about 2,000 meals prepared for people, and he ran out within probably 40 minutes. The Red Cross was there handing out bottles of water and snacks. The trauma was handed out. Each person, we got 4 bottles of water and 3 snacks, including kids. I saw a woman walk up and put a Clorox bottle up to a water spigot, and that's what she filled up with drinking water. She said, it's all I have. They're desperate there. Look, FEMA's there, the military's there, and more of those personnel are on the way. But Don, it's 9 days from the hurricane. Sounds like a broken record. It is. But it's starting to break people's heart. People don't understand. You know, people keep telling me, let's remind the people on the mainland and the government leaders that we are Americans. What is taking you so long?
Yeah, David, I know you traveled to the West Coast. You were describing some of that just a moment ago. What were the roads like there? Are they still blocked? And describe that journey and what you found.
Not at all. The roads aren't blocked at all, and that's an important point. If you're going to the middle of the island where it's mountainous, we're hearing that the roads are impassable. But the roads are fine. We drove 7 miles an hour to get to Agadir. But on the way there, there are people waiting for fuel. Down the lines are a mile long in some places, and they go all night. Okay? Gas stations will close at dark when the curfew goes into effect, but people will stay there. They sleep in their car, and they wait for the gas station to open the next morning. There are also lines at banks, ATMs. The only way you can buy fuel right now is if you have cash.
As you know, the president's administration has repeatedly touted the federal efforts, saying that this is a huge success and that it's a good news story, and that the press is not portraying this fairly. What's your reaction to that, being on the ground since even before the storm happened?
You know, my reaction? Ask the Puerto Rican people.
Well, you've been talking to them, you've been hearing what they say. I know they're grateful for when they do see FEMA and the military there, but is it, I just, every time that we have you on and we have interviews with people, there is both a combination of defeat and desperation there. I mean, are things improving at all, or is it still in a state of stasis?
No. It's still in a state of emergency. God, 9 days later, we're not talking about somebody with a pill. We're talking about rescue. We're talking about finding a place. Listen, I just got a call before I came on scene. Listen. The man who runs Disability Assistance Center in the U.S. that said they are fielding calls from people on this island who are getting in touch with relatives, for example, in this case saying, I haven't had dialysis before, I'm desperate to get it. The dialysis center, it has real power, and we can't have dialysis forever. Listen, the president can say what he wants. The bottom line here is, nobody has said Donald Trump. The only thing they've said is, what is taking U.S. governments off? Where are they? Now, I can tell you what about FEMA's there. FEMA's everywhere. But what we're seeing in Donald Trump? Look, the Red Cross is in Aqua Dee. But there's the one that's 2,000 meals this morning.
Your signal's breaking up a little bit, yeah, but I want to keep talking if we can make sure that we have a good connection with you. Let me ask you this, though. I heard this morning that there is a weather forecast for torrential rain and potential flash floods over the weekend. In your travels, have you seen, do people have shelter? Are there tarps? Are there enough buildings with roofs that people are going to be able to get out of the weather when this hits?
There are tarps.